An abbreviation of a trademark is confusingly similar to the trademark under the UDRP, at least if the domain name registrant is impersonating the trademark owner, or so one UDRP panelist wrote in an interesting dispute involving a three-letter domain name. Hi, it's Doug Isenberg, and the case I'm talking about here involved the domain name brs.contact. Now, .contact is not a popular top-level domain, but it was delegated in 2015 as part of ICANN's expansion of the GTLD system. The registry operator's application for .contact described it as creating the opportunity for anyone to promote a dedicated contact area for customers. But the TLD has not proven very popular, with fewer than 11,000 registrations as of today. In any event, someone registered the domain name brs.contact and apparently began using it in connection with a phishing scheme targeting a French financial services company known as BOURSORAMA, which has more than 2 million customers. BOURSORAMA ended up filing a complaint against the domain name registrant under the UDRP, the Uniform Domain Name Dispute Resolution Policy. The facts of the dispute as I know them are from the UDRP decision in the case, which was written by a panelist at the Czech Arbitration Court in April 2021. BOURSORAMA, according to the UDRP decision, owns a number of domain names for itself, including BOURSORAMA.com, which was registered in 1998, long before the brs.contact domain name was created in 2021, as well as the domain names brsimg.com, brsourama.com, and brsp.app. The decision also says that BOURSORAMA owns several trademarks for BOURSORAMA, but none for BRS, which, as I'll explain, became an important element of this decision. So the threshold question in this case, as it is in all UDRP cases, is whether the disputed domain name was confusingly similar to a trademark in which the complainant had rights. Normally, the test for confusing similarity is straightforward and has even been described as nothing more than a standing requirement. As the WIPO overview says, the test typically involves a side-by-side comparison of the domain name and the textual components of the relevant trademark to assess whether the mark is recognizable within the disputed domain name. But in the BOURSORAMA case, the issue was more complicated because BOURSORAMA did not own any trademark rights in BRS. It only owned trademark rights in BOURSORAMA, which meant that the UDRP panel had to compare BRS to BOURSORAMA, which seemed to raise questions that don't normally arise in UDRP cases, given the differences between the trademark and the domain name here. Now, in some UDRP disputes, abbreviations of domain names are more obvious than seem to be the case here. For example, previous UDRP panels found a domain name that contains the word saint to be confusingly similar to a trademark that contains the letters ST, or the letters BNK in a domain name have been found to be confusingly similar to a trademark that includes the word bank. But here, the letters BRS are at least arguably not immediately clear as an abbreviation for the trademark BOURSORAMA. BRS obviously consists of only three letters from the 10-letter BOURSORAMA trademark, which is not a dictionary word with a common abbreviation, nor do the letters BRS appear together in the BOURSORAMA trademark. So, how did the panelists in this case decide whether the domain name was confusingly similar to the trademark? Well, here's what the decision says. The panel takes the view that the threshold required by the first element of the policy is met. As a matter of fact, the element BRS could indeed be considered as an abbreviation of the BOURSORAMA trademark, as confirmed also by the registration and use by the complainant of domain names composed by BRS, referring to brsimg.com, brsourama.com, and brsp.app. The panel considers of relevance also the way the disputed domain name is used. The complainant has submitted evidence that the respondent used brs.contact to impersonate itself as the complainant. In these documents, the respondent refers to BOURSORAMA as BRS, that is, BOURSORAMA BRS, confirming that BRS could be perceived as an abbreviation of the complainant's trademark. In other words, because the complainant used BRS in its own domain names, and because the domain name registrant impersonated the complainant and also referred to BOURSORAMA as BRS, the panel found that BRS was confusingly similar to BOURSORAMA. Now, under different circumstances, such as if the domain name registrant had used it in connection with the website for something else that used BRS, perhaps Bulk Reef Supply, a real company that provides products for saltwater aquariums, or Blade Runner Systems, a real knife company, then the outcome of this UDRP case would have been different. The important takeaway from this case is that this decision really applies a very broad interpretation of the first element of the UDRP, even implying that how a registrant uses a domain name may be relevant in assessing whether a domain name is confusingly similar to a trademark. And that could be very helpful for other trademark owners, including those who want to use the UDRP to shut down phishing attacks and other deceptive practices. So under this case, a trademark owner that uses, or finds someone else using, an abbreviation of its trademark, or maybe an acronym that conjures up its trademark, may still be able to use the UDRP to its advantage. If you want to learn more about the UDRP, please check out my masterclass on domain name disputes, as well as other resources on my GigaLaw website. And be sure to subscribe to the GigaLaw YouTube channel to be notified of future videos discussing other UDRP cases. Thanks for watching, and see you next time online.